last relationship. Look how good you treated him. You could birth like four of him. Girl, you never needed.
Hey y'all, welcome back to my channel. If you don't know by now, my name is Ellen Marie, aka Ellen, and welcome. So in today's video, I'm going to be showing you guys how I do my wash and go routine with the TGIN Honey Collection. So if you're interested, then keep on watching. To get started, I'm going to take down my hair from the previous week. And in the previous week, I just, towards the end of it, I just decided to put my hair up in a half up, half down style. And you guys can see as I'm taking it down, it's a little dry around the perimeter of my hair. I have a little bit of flakage going on. The back of my hair is very dry. I have a couple of knots and tangles. And towards the front, my curl pattern is showing a little bit, but it could be better. And then when you get to the back, OMG. Y'all know how it is. You just let your hair go after a couple of days. So it is time to rejuvenate, re-moisturize, and just get this hair together. I know y'all see them edges still in there though. So I'm going to go ahead and shampoo and condition, and I'll be right back in a couple seconds. So after shampoo and conditioning, I'm out of the shower and we're going to get started with the TGIN Honey Miracle Hair Mask with raw honey and olive oil. And I have tried this before just to let y'all know, and it's my favorite of all time. Now this is what the consistency is looking like. Not too thick, but it has a thick consistency. It's kind of creamy. Kind of reminds me of cream of wheat in a way, just a little bit smoother. It has a little bit of a chunky texture to it, but it is very moisturizing. It's just everything, okay? This is my favorite. So I do recommend y'all check it out. This is what the consistency is looking like. And let's go ahead and apply it to my hair. So getting out of the shower, this is what my hair is looking like with no product whatsoever. When I apply my deep conditioners, I apply it in sections on freshly clean washed hair. So that's what we're about to do. So I'm going to start in the back. I'm going to take down a section and I'm going to get a generous amount of product. Y'all, now I am very heavy handed. If you don't know, if you don't watch my videos, I'm very heavy handed. But as you can see, once I rub the product into my hand, it smooths out very, very well, which I do like. And I am going to add some water just to thin it down a little bit so it can really distribute to all of my hair strands. But as I said, I really love this, so I already know it's going to work for me. This is the only product in the collection that I've tried, so I do recommend for y'all to get it because it's the bomb.com. But yes, I apply a generous amount. After applying it to my actual hair, I'm going to apply a little bit more to my ends, and then I'm going to go ahead and apply some to my roots. I am a huge and firm believer in applying product to your roots, especially if you have more coarser and thicker hair like me. It's just gonna help your hair lay a little bit flatter, tame your hair a little bit, and just help with those puffy roots that I just happen to get all the time. I think it's just in the genetics and my hair, so I just make sure to apply product to that section of my hair and just apply it until you feel as though it's thoroughly worked in. And if you don't feel like it's worked in, then I go ahead and use a shampoo detangling brush. And after using my detangling brush to just smooth it in and make sure all the product is throughout my whole entire head and hair strands, I'm going to go ahead and twist it up. I'm not going to twist it as tight as I would if I was doing a twist out, but I'm going to twist it just good enough for my twist to stay intact throughout this whole process. Now I want y'all to really look at my hair and see how my hair is just drinking up this product. It's drinking it up like that is lotion and I am dry skin. Yeah, I just want y'all to look at that because that just tells you that your hair is really liking the product if it's soaking it up. And watch how I am really putting product on my roots. This is going to help you with dry roots, puffy roots, dandruff on your scalp. Maybe your scalp's a little dry a little bit. Just... I'm going to take a little bit more and I'm going to apply it to the top of my hair where I really didn't get a lot. And I'm going to put it around the perimeter of my hair and the nape of my neck just to make sure that I'm really getting my roots and my edges, just to make sure they are getting the most moisture that I can give them. And after that, I'm going to take a plastic bag. I'm going to put that on my head and I'm going to get my Glow By Day Deep Conditioning Cap. And I'm going to sit under this for about 30 minutes to an hour, however I feel. Now while in the shower, I'm going to rinse my hair and I'm going to apply this TGIN Sweet Honey Hair Milk as my leave-in conditioner, because I'm not sure if they have one. If they do, then I didn't get it. But here I'm showing you guys the consistency and what it looks like. It's very thin. It comes out looking thicker than what it is, but it's very thin consistency and it's kind of watery in my opinion. So right after getting out of the shower, this is what I'm looking like. As I said, I applied the leave conditioner in the shower, and this is what my hair is looking like. Now while in the shower, when I applied the hair milk, I did apply a generous amount, as you can see, because my hair is kind of white, but not too white, so my hair did absorb it very well, but at the same time it didn't. Now I do want to say that these products do have silicone, so that may be a difference between them really absorbing into my hair. But overall, I really do like it. It's more of a thinner consistency than I would usually like my leave-in conditioners to be, but it's gonna work for this style. Now on to our last product, which is the TGIN Curl Bomb Moisturizing Styling Gel. This is the gel that I'm gonna be using to set my curls in place. This is the consistency. Now when I started to feel and touch it, it felt kind of thick on the thicker side, but as you rub it in and work it into your hand, it smooths out and thins out very, very much. Okay, so that was a little scary for me because I like thick gels, but we're gonna see how this goes. So this is my hair with just the leave-in conditioner in, so I'm gonna go ahead and section off a small piece for me to start working the gel into my hair. Now on the first couple of pieces, I applied 2 to 3 pumps of the gel, and upon first application it felt very, very thin. It was very, very thin. It felt like water basically going into my hair, and I was kind of scared and it wasn't doing anything. And y'all can see here that my curls aren't forming in any shape or form, so I was a little scared. So I decided to add some more, and then I realized that my hands were kind of flaking up just a tad bit, and it was only like maybe a couple of flakes. So I was like, okay, I'm gonna go ahead and add some more gel. And I just wish I didn't do that, but I did. I kept going. And as I added more gel to my hair, my curls started to form. It looked a little better. I still had some flakes going on. Don't ask me why I didn't stop adding it, but don't ask me because I can't tell you. I just really wanted the products to work. So I said, I'm going to do this. And then my curls, y'all see this, those curls, they started to form. And I just wanted it to work. So I was overlooking the flakes and looking at the curls, and the gel was kind of giving my hair some weight. So I was like, I don't know, but we're gonna see how it goes. So I kept on going. I kept applying my water and applying enough gel. Now I will say I did have to apply a lot of gel, because the gel was so lightweight to me, and it felt like just putting water on my hair if I only added like 3 pumps to the one small section that I'm doing. So if you're into lighter hold gels, maybe this.
Check the mic and make sure it sound right, boys. Sound right, boys.
Sound. sound white, boy.
I don't know if y'all can tell, but I can see it on this certain section. This was the only section that did that to me. It started to foam up like a lot. I think it was the water and the gel coming together. I'm not sure why I did that, but I just wanted to put that in here. That was a little off for me. So still don't know why I didn't say to myself, why don't you stop? Because this is not working. Something is going on. But we're not gonna talk about that. So yeah. While it was still wet, so I just applied some of the Shea Moisture Mister or Body Fight Mister, and then this Palmer's Coconut, it's like essential oils type of thing. Well, I just sprayed it all over my hair. I made sure to get a good amount because I did apply a lot of gel and I did not want to experience a lot dryness or flakage. But this is where it goes wrong, y'all. I'm over here praying to my hair, but it just didn't work out for me. This is about 30 to 40 minutes of me trying to diffuse and blow dry my hair so it can be dry. And as you can see, I'm experiencing a lot of flakes. There are flakes everywhere. I've never had my hair flake like this. And it was just terrible. It was horrific. It was terrible. And I was so angry. I do not recommend using these products together. You can maybe use them separate apart. They work fine, and since then I have tried the gel with another product and it has done phenomenal. So I just suggest do not to do that. But I'm just gonna go ahead and rinse out my hair. I'm really upset about it. I wanted to put this video out to show you all that your hair is not gonna always turn out great, and certain product combos are not gonna always work. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Don't forget to give it a big thumbs up, and I will see you guys in my next video. Peace, love you.
I like me better when I was yours. I'm going back, I'm going back.